artists, welcome to another project video. Last week it was Earth Day, April 22nd. That got me inspired into looking for materials that we all have in our houses that we can recycle to create more art. And the materials that I'm going to use for this project, I'm pretty sure you have some. You can also grab the napkin rolls. They're a little bit longer, but you can cut it out for this project. Once you have collected one or two of these rolls, then we can go ahead and start our project. So let's make. So before we do anything, let me show you how to mark and cut a napkin roll to the size of toilet paper one. Place them flat on the table and mark the lines right at the top all around the roll and simply cut. My roll gave me two toilet paper roll sizes and a little bit extra. Ask someone to help you cut if it feels too hard.
Bye.
Ask someone to help you if it feels too hard to cut through. Next, we are going to fold one half of the top edge of the roll down towards the center, and then the other half the same. You will create these little spikes on the sides, and those will be our owl ears. Then magically appear whatever marker you have or a black pen, and we can begin our owl drawing. At the top middle, let's start with two big circles next to each other, then smaller circles inside. I like to add a third little circle on top, and this will be the highlight of the eye. In the middle of both eyes, we will do a beak. This will be pointing down. Follow an invisible line from the top to the bottom, staying as much in the middle as you can, and draw 1 foot on each side. These are half circles. Don't forget to do this both sides of the roll. Then our owls will share wings, so they will be at the sides. It starts at 1 foot, goes up and around through the side, and lands on the other side's feet. Repeat on both sides. Then add all the patterns and details in the wings, the chest, around the eyes, ears, and everywhere. Get creative with your patterns, but keep it simple and consistent. And when you're done, it's just time to color. We are all about recycling here, and so I'm recycling this aluminum foil paint paper to do my paint. You can paint or color your owl depending on the materials you have. I will paint one and color the other one with crayons. One important tip is to hold your owl with your non-dominant hand from the inside of the tube. And don't be afraid of turning it around and upside down to make sure that you got every single part of your toilet paper roll. With paint, you can layer colors. Just make sure to let them dry very well in between layers. You can add texture by dotting the brush around to make it look like feathers. Then, if you have a black paint, go around your details to clean up. If you don't have black paint, you can use the same black marker or pen from the beginning to outline. If you don't have any paint, you can still use markers, color pencils, or crayons. Like I said, I will use crayons. Do you want to know my secret to make my coloring look more 3D? I start with the light colors first. So like here, I'm doing my owl blue. So I got the light blue first and then color the whole area. Then I got a darker blue and only color around the edges of the drawing. To blend my colors, I like doing little circles very softly until both colors are combined. Remember to change colors for the beak and feet and the wings to make your owl a lot more interesting. And here they are. I did a lot of owls. You can use them as puppets or decorations and have a lot of fun with them. And that's it, you guys. I hope you had a lot of fun with this project too. Don't forget to post it or send it to me. You know where to find me. And I'll send you big hug and a squeeze this time because I miss you so much every day. I'll see you in the next video. Bye!